Hello everyone, welcome back to Lublumani. My name is Abby and today's video is going to be the third Slim Thick Thursdays video. So we are going on week three now. So if you're interested in seeing what week three's workouts are, how my body has changed so far, and just a general check-in about how the workout is going, then go ahead and keep on watching. You really just whipped it up on camera like that? Sure did. Yeah, so it's important for me that this channel is a realistic depiction of a human being. So during this video, I'm going to be taking out these braids that I put my hair in to stretch my hair. And I think ultimately the goal is that I want people to be used to seeing Black girls when they're not like fully 100% put together. I think there's like, we're held to such really high standards and we always have to have like our face beat and our hair done and our edges laid and all that stuff. And I think that's just a lot of pressure and I want to be the change I want to see in the world. So I'm just going to normalize like being seen when I look less presentable, and I want my channel to like be a reflection of like my beliefs, and I think that's super important. So throughout this video, you're gonna see me in this state. Hopefully by the end of the video, I will have taken all the braids out so you can see the full fro, but y'all have seen it before already, so it's not that exciting. But yeah, that's why I'm taking my hair out of braids right now, and I'm looking a little bit crazy. But anyways, back to Slim Thick Thursdays. This week was definitely harder, because I remember last week it was not a big deal. If I forgot, and I just had to do it in my bed, I would do it in my bed, and I wasn't really that mad about it. It was like just whatever. This week though, I'm not gonna say I was dreading it, but like it would be on my mind a little bit more, and I would just kind of be like, oh my goodness, like there's so many to do now. And I think the biggest problem as I'm getting into like these higher and higher numbers of like crunches and higher numbers of the glute bridges, it's a lot of counting. And I know for me, whenever I do workouts that involve me keeping track of things, I'm just not good at counting and I end up losing track. And because I don't want to be cheating the workout, I end up like repeating myself. And it's just really annoying. You're paying such close attention to the counting that you end up super aware of where you are in the workout. And like for me, I like to kind of get lost in other things so that I don't have to think so hard about how much I'm doing. So like I'll be counting and I'll be at like 100 and 150 and whatever, and I'll just be constantly doing the math on how many I have left because there's so many of them. What I discovered yesterday, which was game changing, and I'm really glad I found it, and I'll be using it for the next 2 weeks until this challenge is over, is I just looked up on YouTube like an interval timer, but not an interval timer. I wanted something that would count for me so that I would know how many I had done without counting every single movement. Basically, it was just like a minute timer that every single second it would beep and I could just stick to the rhythm and it wouldn't count the number out loud. It would just play the beep. So I wouldn't have to count every single one. And all you have to do, instead of keeping track of every single second, you just keep track of how many times you've watched, like played the video. So as long as you can keep track of that, you don't have to count and you can watch TV and do other things and not worry about it. So that was really nice. So definitely check out this video. And oh, another thing I need to be honest about is this week on, I film these videos on Wednesdays and I post them on Thursday. So Thursday becomes like the beginning of a new week. And so on Thursday, I'm on day one. But I remember last week, I actually didn't do day one. So I remember, I think I just completely blanked on it or I got tired or something. I think I blanked on it, honestly, and didn't do it. And so what I did was I counted Thursday last week as my break day, and then I did every other day after that, and I ignored the day four rest day. And that's how I kept myself on track. But I do remember that I forgot that. So if that happens to you, just rearrange yourself to hold yourself accountable. If you need to like double up days, this is a workout you can very easily do that because like it's not like you're doing something super involved. It's probably only about 15 minutes. So if you're behind, do the one you're behind on in the morning and then do the one for that day in the night. So yeah, don't like beat yourself up about like getting behind or forgetting or falling asleep or whatever it is that kept you from finishing. Just try to catch up and hold yourself accountable and make sure you're doing every single workout. And if you have to double up days to finish it, then finish it. So this is the point in the video where I can show you guys what my body is looking like now. So that should be somewhere on the screen. And yeah, so you're seeing a difference in my booty, hopefully just a little bit. And I don't know, my abs, I'm not like super happy with them yet. I've never really been that unhappy with them, but I'd like to see a little more blah, blah, boom, you know? It's a very simple workout and it's very straightforward. So that means it's gonna take a bit more for me to see results, but I'm expecting a good turnaround week three and week four, or at least seeing a little more definition just because this is where the reps are getting to the point where like it's actually gonna be hard for me, because so far it's not been pleasant, but it's not been like impossible. And I think I'm getting to the point where it might be a little impossible. For week three, what I would say is this is where we're getting into like 500, 600, 700 crunches and stuff. So if you want to break things in half, because you've gotten this far, you know you can do 350, 400 crunches at a time. That's great. So if you want to break up week three into, okay, the 600 day is coming, I'm going to do two sets of 300. Do that if you think you need a break in between. And it makes it more manageable for you. If you think it's harder to stop and start again, then just push on through. But like, don't make yourself feel bad if you need to take breaks, is all I want to say. Because this is not a workout that's supposed to make you feel bad about anything. Because I think sometimes when you're following a routine, it's easy to like get guilty and be like, oh my goodness, I'm not doing this perfectly, whatever. And this is definitely not like what we want to be doing. I think this workout is about building confidence, building discipline, and being patient with your body and being patient with yourself. After not working out for a while.
Okay, y'all, so here is the workout for week three as I get my hair all nice and floofed, and as usual, you can find it in the description box down below.
Okay, y'all, so now my hair is about as floofed as it's probably gonna get this video. Now I can leave this video being satisfied that I look like a natural queen or whatever, and just be leading by example that your natural hair, if you're out there, is gorgeous. I love it. Your 4C hair, it's fabulous. It's powerful. It has dimension. Even when you put it in those little braids and you feel like you need to put it under a bonnet, if you don't feel like putting it under a bonnet, I'm not judging you and no one else should be. And that was kind of the point of me doing my hair throughout this video. If you have been following along, please let me know somehow how it's been going. People have been DMing me on Instagram that they're doing the workout or thinking about joining in and doing it. And that makes me so excited. And hearing how it's going for other people also makes me so excited. So please let me know how it's going for you, either in the comments down below or on my Instagram, which is 14_Abby. You should definitely check me out. I post weekly and then also post on my story like constantly. So yeah, but yeah, that's the whole video. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.